Professor, this map was made by my great-grandfather. I think I'd know if we were heading in the right direction.
I understand that, but my old bone catches the drop sometimes. Knowing your father, he was a very adventurous chap like you.
We're gonna have to camp out here at some point.
Oh, George, are you sure that's a good idea? Can we go a little further?
Well, if we went any further now, we might run into something.
Very well, let's go. That overlook right there might be pretty good. Oh man, I miss back home. Not having to worry about any bugs, insects, any wild creatures that could eat us.
I'd know about some creatures that could probably tear us to shreds in this forest.
I doubt anything could top a jaguar.
Have you ever heard of a grinner?
Grinner? What the devil is a grinner?
Exactly.
Look at this view, George. It's incredible, George. Look at this. Where exactly did you say we were?
Totar, sir. This has been my homeland for quite some time. It has some quite interesting creatures here.
What exactly kind of creatures? Jaguars? Monkeys? Baboons?
Well, those are some of the more common ones. The ones that show up at night are a little...
Night, you say? Well, a good thing we brought a bunch of sleeping bags.
I've already got the fire set up, so I guess this is the best place for the night. At least we know we're near that one place.
Exactly, George. After this old knee injury, I'm not as surprised as I once was, but it'd be nice to have some sort of rest.
So, why did you come to Totar anyway?
I heard legends of some sort of ruin out here. Have a portal. Be able to travel to other worlds, apparently.
And what were you hoping to do with this?
Solve all the problems of mankind here.
But what about those other realities? What happens to them?
Well, it's for the greater good of mankind here.
But what about the other mankind?
I need to rest. Why don't we go any further? Why didn't we camp out so early, George?
Well, tale tells about a creature with a horrifying smile.
Horrifying smile, you say?
They say if you stare into its eyes long enough, given that it has eyes, it will show your soul screaming back at you to look away.
What do you mean, if it has eyes?
Well, you see, they can have eyes or no eyes, horns or no horns, multiple limbs. We've had people come into our hospitals with multiple mental illnesses because of these creatures.
Poppycock.
That's what the last person said who went into our hospital.
And he was to be right, probably. But I cannot believe you until I see it. Are we almost there, George?
Well, you just passed these trees.
Just my imagination. Continue on. So, George, tell me more about these shadow creatures.
Depends on what you're talking about. You mean grinner or the screamer?
The grinner is the one I'm more interested in.
Well, grinner has a forefront smile. A person was hiking down this area, actually.
Yes.
And he saw a black orb zoom past his peripheral vision.
Ah, the bugs are very disgusting, I must say.
And he didn't think much of it, so he continued hiking on.
Yes, of course.
He ran out of nowhere. He died. Just dropped dead.
Well,
another person found him.
He reached the street. So, what about this, what was it called? What was the other one? That's the grinner, but the
screamer?
The screamer, yes.
So, I think it might have been what we saw back there. So, the screamer is a little bit more unsettling than any of the other ones that I did.
George,
it's right there. Just where I was leading you. The temple between dimensions.
Quite a sight.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Let's go in.
This is it. This is what we've been searching for 2 bloody years.
Oh, at least we got something.
Wait.
Oh!
Something. Well, that was the worst.